And we're here with another video. Now, today I'm going to show you how you can create a fixed controller using something other than the rotate tool. So you might have noticed that whenever I create like a switch, I've always used the rotate tool. Well, this is not the only way. Okay, so I'm going to remove this right now, and I'm going to be using my circle tool here to act as my switch. And let's go ahead and set things up. Select the spline tool here. I'm just gonna create 2 points like so. Let me put that in a folder. Now, I'm going to be attaching my circle here to the spline tool because I want the controller to be fixed. So I'm gonna select both of those, left click on the origin point for my circle here, right click somewhere in between the 2 points of my spline, and click on link to spline to link it to the spline. And I'm going to turn off that layer. And now if I move from left to right, you can see that it's fixed onto the spline like so. Now I'm going to be creating something to switch out. So I'm just going to use my star tool here and place that in a folder. And I'm just going to create something else, like whatever this shape is, and I'm going to place that in a group as well. And I'm going to place the both of these inside of a group like that. And I'm going to set up this group layer to be a switch. So in its properties, I'm going to just select Z range. And then we can, if we open it up, we can see that both of them are still there. It's just displaying one at a time. And I'm going to use my switch, of course, to switch between the two layers. So select the switch, i.e. the circle. And well, first let's go ahead and set up the switch layer. So go back to the layer group, and where it says Z range position, right click that, and we want to convert that to a integer. And I'm going to be exporting the link here into my library. So I'm going to call this change, but you can name it whatever you want. Open up this in my library here, make sure that we have that selected. I'm going to go to my controller here, and so I'm going to open up the origin point here, or the origin property, and where it says amount, I'm just going to right click that, convert, and we want to convert this to an integer. So we have two similar properties here to connect. Remember, it won't connect unless you have similar properties. Okay, so select the link here, make sure that this is selected in the library, and right click over here and click on connect. Now if I move this from left to right, we see that it switches out the shapes. Okay, so that's pretty much how you would create a switch, well, a fixed switch, without using the typical rotate tool that I always use, which is this tool here. Okay, even though I like using this tool because it gives me more variety, but now you know that this is not the only way to create a controller. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. Hope you learned something new, and I will see you in the next video.